Hello everyone, myself Satish Thalange, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Technology, Solapur. In today's session, we are going to study regarding the measurement of workability with the compaction factor test. At the end of the session, the student is going to learn the carry out the tests relevant to the measurement of workability of the fresh concrete as per the Indian Standard Code for the compaction factor test. Along with that, he is going to understand and take a necessary decision on the factor which are going to affect on the workability of the concrete. Now we'll see what is a compaction factor test. The compaction factor test is a workability measurement of the fresh concrete, or you can say the green concrete. The compaction factor test has been developed at the Road Research Laboratory by the UK. The test is designed primarily used in the laboratory, but it can also be used in the field. We have to refer the IS codes like IS 1199-1959 and SP 23-1982 for the procedure and the regarding the steps to be carried out for the compaction factor test. It is more precious and the sensitive than the slum test, which is one of the measurement workability test for the concrete. Test is applied on the concrete mix of very low workability as are normally used when the concrete is to be compacted or vibrated. The test is applied to the plain and the air entrained concretes made with the light weights, normal weight or heavy aggregates having the nominal maximum size of 30 mm or less, but not to be concrete or not a fine aggregates. If the size of aggregate is more than 38 mm, the concrete shall be wet sieved through the 8.1 mm sieve screen, and it should be the largest particles more than 38 mm should be removed. Now this is a slide which is showing the compaction factor test apparatus. Yes, you observe that there is a two stages in the apparatus showing. One in the hoppers, two hoppers are there, and at the bottom there is a cylinder, and there are various tools which are used for the filling of the concrete in the hoppers at the top, and the following steps are to be carried out. I mean, there are the sequence to carry out the steps. Now let's see the sequence to carry out the compaction factor test. Now these are the tests to be performed for the compaction factor test. Place the concrete sample gently in the upper hopper to its brims using the hand scoop and level it. After that, open the trap door at the bottom of the upper hopper so that the concrete fall into the lower hopper as by the gravitational force. On the falling on the lower hopper, after that open the trap door of the lower hopper and allow the concrete to fall in the cylinder below. As shown here, these are the first hopper, second hopper, and the last there is a cylinder. Okay. Now cut off the excess of the concrete above the top level of the cylinder using the trowel, or the level it by the tamping rod, and clean the excess concrete which is fell down. After that, weight the empty cylinder. Let we name it, or you can say in the short we will say W1. Now weight the cylinder with the concrete felt by the free fall, that is why the gravitational fall, to the nearest to the 100 grams. In short, we define it WFF, that is weight for free fall, and this weight is to known as the weight of the partially compacted concrete, that is WP is equal to WFF minus W1. That is the weight for the partly compaction concrete. Now after that, we have to empty the cylinder, and then we have to refill it, the concrete in the cylinder, by a proper appropriate 5 cm depth, and we have to compact it by the compacting rod for each layer. After filling the cylinder, again we have to level it by the trowel, or you can say the tamping rod. That filled cylinder we have to weight again, that is a weight of the cylinder with the fully compacted, that's we are saying WHCC. This weight is known as the weight of the fully compacted concrete, WF is equal to WHCC minus W1. Now there are the observation tables, or you can say observations and the calculations. The compaction factor is defined as the ratio of the weight of the partly compacted concrete to the weight of the fully compacted concrete. But these are the following readings which should be noted during the practical performance. First, we should note the weight of the empty cylinder. After that, we have to weight the cylinder which is filled by the concrete freely. That is the second reading. And after that, we have to record the reading regarding the weight of cylinder plus the concrete which is filled in the cylinder by the compacting process by the hand. Now, lastly, the fourth reading is weight of the partly compacted concrete. These are the WP is equal to WFF minus W1. Weight of fully compacted concrete, that is WF is equal to WHCC minus W1. And how to calculate the compaction factor is equal to, as well as we have defined earlier in the first line, that is, it is a ratio of the weight of partly compacted concrete divided by the weight of fully compacted concrete. Now, we will see some of the recommendations by the, the IS for the following conditions of construction works. Now, for the concreting of the shallow section with the vibration, this is a condition, and the degree of workability, you can say, that is very low, and the compaction factor is low. It's ranging from 0.75 to 0.80. Now, concreting of lightly reinforced sections with the vibration, the degree is low, and the compaction factor for that is particularly 0.80 to 0.85. Now, for the condition like concreting of a light reinforced sections without vibration or heavily reinforced sections with the vibration, the degree is medium and its compaction factor is ranging from 0.85 to 0.92. Now, concreting of heavily reinforcement sections without vibration, the degree of workability is high and the compaction factor is above 0.92. Here, we have to keep in mind, as per the client, what is the requirement, we have to guess, we have to take the note down from that, and according to that, we have to design our compaction factor. Now, this is a mixture consistency based on the compaction factor. Now, the consistency are very dry, very hard, plastic, liquid, and high liquid. Now, when we see the compaction factor for the very dry, it is 0.70. For very hard, it is 0.78. Very hard, it is 0.7. And for the hard, it is 0.85. And the plastic hard, it is 0.89. And for the plastic, it is 0.92. And for the liquid, it is 0.95. And high liquid, it is 1. So keep in mind that we have to see, as per the requirement, we have to define the particular consistency for the concrete and along with that its compaction factor. Finally, let's select the correct answer for this MCQs for based upon the today's session. The first question is, which test is used for low workability concrete? These are the four options: slump test, compaction factor test, both AB, none of this. And the second question is, what is the compaction factor for the medium degree of workability? That is 0.78, 0.85, 0.92, 0.95. I will pause for 1 minute. Just answer. Hope so you have selected this answer. For the first MCQ, it is compaction factor test. And for the maximum compaction factor for the medium degree of workability is 0.92. Okay. These are the references for the today's session. Thank you.